time, ticket ting time, ticket ting time, 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 ticket ting time, ticket ting time, 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 ticket ting time, ticket ting time, 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 ticket ting time, ticket ting time.
Castello di Monsanto is located in the central west side of the Chianti Classico denomination, in the beautiful wine region of Tuscany between the two cities of Florence and Siena. The winery is named after the village of Monsanto in the tiny hamlet dating back to 998. The name Monsanto translates Holy Mountain. In the Middle Ages, there was a missionary in the area named Ruffignano, and the church paid homage to him by calling the village Holy Mountain. The winery has been producing wine since 1700 and was owned by a family from Florence. In 1961, my grandfather Aldo, who was born nearby in San Gimignano, fell in love with the landscape and decided to buy the property. My grandmother Anna was born in Piedmont and he had experience producing wine. She, my grandfather Aldo, and my father Fabrizio discovered the beautiful wines preserved in the cellar, and the adventure began. In 1964, my father and my mother were married and they received the winery as their wedding gift. They put all their love, passion, and dedication to renovate the cellar, to plant new vineyards, select the best clones of Sangiovese, and experiment with fermentation techniques. Their goal was to show the incredible winemaking potential of this area. Fabrizio was revolutionary with the denomination. In 1962, he created the first Chianti Classico Cru with the single vineyard Il Poggio. In 1968, he eliminated the use of the white grapes in the Chianti Classico blend. In 1968, he planted the first single vineyard named Scanni with 100% Sangiovese. And in 1976, a pure Cabernet Sauvignon vineyard was first planted. As I grew up, the wine passion and curiosity of my parents naturally was passed into me. I did attend law school, but after receiving my law degree, I realized that my dream was not to be a lawyer. At the end of the 80s, I started to work at the winery. I began in the vineyards and in the cellar. I worked side by side with people who were taking care of all the everyday aspects of the winemaking. They gave me a priceless education that I'm completely thankful for. My father's revolution quickly became my traditions. I'm deeply convinced that all the good that has been made in the past need to be respected forever. With this philosophy, we made Castello di Monsanto the classic Chianti Classico.